Good evening, everyone. My name is Ufushi Kelani. We are here today to understand more about our AX 2012 platform. We'll be talking about a specific major topic and an important document, that's our management reporter. As you already know, my name is Ufushi Kelani, and I'm a Microsoft Certified Trainer and a Solution Architect as well. Corporate Trainer at Koenig Solutions Private Limited, so working here since last three and a half years. I also have and been as a functional consultant in Microsoft ERP, successfully delivered multiple corporate trainings globally as such, and handling a lot of individual clients. I hold almost 17 years of my work experience, mainly into the education field, and has been my strength as a part of my career journey. Today, when we go ahead, we are going to talk about a specific topic and a very, very important document that we always have in our minds and our organization functions on. That is your management reporting. So our agenda for the day is going to be mainly to introduce and understand about management reporting. What are the components to those reports and the building blocks? Building blocks is all about the different attributes which are going to be added to your reporting structures. Let's understand first, what is a management reporting as such? A lot of people we know, we are coming from different domains, different platforms, understanding. We also understand the fact of the day is, wherever there is a legal entity, an organization, the performance of the organization all depends on the financial reports. To understand where do we are lacking or where are we standing in today's time. For that, we need to have our financial reports rightly created and in place. That's how we are going to discuss about our management reporting today. What is management reporting? A management reporter is a real-time financial reporting application which is designed to empower information workers to quickly and easily create, generate, secure and publish financial statements. Maybe they are as profit and loss statements, balance sheets, and cash flow reports. It also mainly performs with one just said module, which is our general ledger. So that's how it says, pulls information from the general ledger module. Actively works and supports our different ERP platforms, works with AX, GP, and FNO application. A lot of people here in the today's session are also going to be known to AX as well as the other ERP platforms also. Just to give you a little example, there are a lot of setups in our finance and operations ERP platform. That's our Dynamics 365. Whereas in AX, it was very simply designed and made us understood about how to create and generate financial reports. So today we are going to see how are we going to play around and manage different report formats in our AX 2012. All right. So before we go ahead, let me just take you back to the platform. Here comes our platform, which is our Dynamics AX 2012. Now, a lot of people will be aware and known to this platform, but as a little idea and a little basic understanding about the platform, people who are very new to the platform also, I'll take you with a couple of basic pointers over here. I go to my home page and here we start. On the left hand side here, what you see is all about my navigation pane. Whenever I click on any of the specific modules, my area page starts. Just like we talk about a terminology called expand and collapse. Similarly, here in AX, we have this every module. Whenever we click on, we have called a section called an expanded view, which is more of an area page. So if you see, whenever I click a specific module, my navigation path over here reflects the collapsed view of my submodules inside the main module, and the expanded view, which is my area page about the same submodules here. So it's more of a functionality where we can call this particular function as an expanded and collapsed view on our platform. Every particular page also has the navigation pathway. Now, after that, whenever I want to swipe between our legal entities, I have this navigation path where I can change my legal entities as well. So if I click down on my arrow button here, I will have all the legal entities which are there available on my system. I can just swipe between the legal entities the way I want. In every legal entity, I can also talk about the different modules that I want to work with. So this arrow button is going to help you next to the legal entity to work with different modules from right from this navigation pathway or also from the navigation pane right here. So you can just enter your legal entity and work with modules right from here, or you can also click from the arrow button here and play with your different modules and understand what are the different functionalities in every module. Similarly, there is another important functionality on our platform on the right bottom corner over here where my cursor is hovering around. This particular tab is known as my status bar. Status bar is more of a personalized feature, the way you want the information to be highlighted on your system. Whether you want your legal entity name, whether you want which module are you into, the date and time and everything. If I say this particular status bar as a personalized feature, a lot of people will have this query, how can I change and hide and unhide the features that I want over the status bar? Very quickly, we can just go to the left-hand side top corner here, click on the file menu, scroll down to tools, under tools, yes, we have an option button, click on options, and I come into the setup page. Let's allow the system to open up. Now here comes my options. These are all my fast tabs where I can have my personalized features. So just to have a little overview before we go ahead on our main agenda, this is here as a general. So this is more of a setup, general user options. Then you have different notification setups, more of an action center, the kind of updates, notifications of your task completions. These are the options where you can have the setups done. Delegation is assigning your task to one of the existing users in your absence. So it's more of a delegation of the job to another user. And there we come about status bar, the exact bar that we were talking about. So when we talk about status bar, I will give you a small little example how we can have the setups and changes as per our own requirements. Let me just drag this little up. Now I can see my status bar. Let me just simply uncheck the clock button. When I uncheck the clock button and just close it, you will see the time will move out of my status bar. That's a simple little example that I am showing it to you. Let's close this. All right. You'll be able to see the changes that the clock has moved out. So this is about my status bar. After this, let me just come back with my time here again, going back to the tools, going back to options, and checking back the clock button over here in my status bar as a fast tab. Click on show clock, simply close it, and my clock is back. All right, so we are back to the normal role center. Now you will ask me, what is this new terminology, what the trainer is using right here? When I click on my home button, this particular thing, as ideally we know as a dashboard, is known as a role center, which gives you a summarized view of your legal entity to understand the financial performances, organization performance indicators, different activities, contributions, sales performances, and so on. So there are a lot of other activities that you will have on the role center, mainly known as a dashboard in a basic understanding for y'all as a terminology. Coming back to our main agenda, as I showed you on my slide over here, let me just go back to my presentation. When we were talking about pulls information from the general ledger, so our major intervention and our major interaction is going to be with this specific module called general ledger. So let's just go back. When I click on the general ledger module, I have all these submodules in the expanded view. That's my area page. I'm going to keep on repeating the technical terminologies so that we become very much used to those terms. So on the area page, I have an option called reports over here. Under reports, I have a very specific option called management reporter. This is the form that my total session is going to be dependent on. So let me just click on management reporter. Once that management designer, the report designer is open, On the left-hand side, a lot of people might be already aware, this is all about the elements that I'm going to work with to run a specific individual report or maybe to generate a new report. For example, I'm just going to collapse all these, scroll down, default report definition. Then I expand this. These are some set formats which have been created on my system. Now, when I say the set formats, that means Microsoft has already created some specific formats on our system and given it as a template to us with an understanding that irrespective to any particular industry, these are some common formats that every organization would run through or require. So that's how we have some default report definitions. That means default report templates that is going to be highlighted over here. Let me just show you one quick example to run the default templates as well. I'm just going to consider one of the default templates. Let me just run through the balance sheet. Now, once I click on this, I get this page over here. Exactly above the form, I have this navigation pane. That is my action pane. I have a button called generate. So the moment I click on this specific template, this button gets enabled for me. That means I can run that template to run a specific report in my date format. Now, before I say generate, let me set up the parameters and the filters in place that I want my report to be generated on those parameters. Here, we can talk about the different legal entities. So let me just go back to my USMF. After that, I have this particular option called detail level. Now, detail level here is going to make you understand that is, on what parameters do you want the report to run on? Just the financials? Do you want financials and accountings? Or do you want financial accounting and transactions as well? So I'm going to keep it as common on all the three parameters. I want to run my report based on this filter, which is linked to my detail level. That is posted activities only, posted and unposted activities or unposted activities only. As we are talking about financial reports, my friends, financial reports are always about the things that you have completed and what's the kind of a status that we are in as an organization. So definitely I'm going to look for posted activities only. Once I click that, I come to the second option where it talks about currency information. When I talk about currency information, it gives you a flexibility to run the report in different currencies that are available with yours. So you can include all reporting currencies as well. The third part of this format is going to talk about like on what parameters, on what base periods do you want to run that report on? I'm going to say the base period as 12. That is my months that I'm talking about. Base year, I can have the year that I want to run my report on. So right now I'm just going to keep it as 2018. Period covered is going to be automatically linked to my base period. Report date and the default base period based on the filter that on what filter do you want to run that report on? So I'm just going to keep it as last period. After that, we'll be touching down and we'll be talking about building blocks again. So right now it's about the default thing which is connected over here. I'm going to keep that setup as it is. Why? Because I'm going to talk about this in detail when we create our own financial report, own report. So right now I'm just going to say generate. So this is what we are going to do for a default template to run. So let me just say generate. All right, I have to refresh it. It takes a little time to run the specific report. It's in the queued form. Let me just run this. See, the status is keep changing based on the database which is there. So we need to allow some time and little patience on our processing. Let me just keep refreshing it. All right, there comes my messages and the status is complete. Automatically, the system, once it is ready, it will automatically view my report on the screen. So let me just refresh it again. And let's wait for the report to get displayed on my screen. I understand we need to be very patient here when it starts off. Let me just try to regenerate it so that we can be really quick. I just want to show you the kind of report that gets generated on the screen. Okay, it takes time. So now here is my report. So if you see, okay, the earlier report has also taken time and it's got generated on our screen. So we are lucky enough to have two different reports on our screen to be viewed at one single time. Let's take the advantage of this report. Now, once this is the default report template which gets run, and based on the year that you have asked for, they will be giving you the status form. Now, this is how your report is going to get generated. All right. So this was something that we have seen to run a specific default template. Now, let's go back to the interesting part where we are going to talk about how to create our own report. So I'm just going to take you back to the presentation first. Let's touch down a little concepts, and then we will come back on our platform. Here we are going to create, maintain, deploy financial statements, efficiently design various types of reports, supports of financial dimensions, no additional tools or configurations required, because it was one single click on your reports, that is management reporter, and you have the report in place. Use this report designer to create building blocks. A lot of people would have come with a curiosity, like what are building blocks? What the trainer is talking about building blocks. So we are going to understand those building blocks as well. Use cases here. A financial accountant needs to create reports that will support the company in the month-end close process. So that's only one single management reporter under the reports and general ledger module that's going to help us with all the consolidation, financial reports, management reporting packages, reporting by subsidiaries, and an accountant will be supported with all the reports that's going to support the company in the month-end close processes. The basics here that when we create a specific report is the row definitions, column definitions, and tree definitions. Tree definition is something that you have optional as a feature, where you can include more of your organization hierarchy as an additional feature or an additional filter to run a specific report that you have created or you are generating from a default definition as well. So we are going to touch down and see how the row definitions are in place, how the column definitions are created. So these are some basic understanding of our creations of the reports. Coming towards the building blocks, we have different components. A report designer, definitely the same thing that we have seen where we need to design a report, that is combine building blocks to define a report. Report designer is a place where you actually create your own format. Report schedules is the report generation regular. So that's a schedule, the report generation of the regular part. So we find different report schedules. Then we have row definition, where we will talk about how the different rows are going to be imparted, how the rows are going to be defined, what are the values that you're going to put up in the rows, how the formulas are going to be put up in the rows, how are you going to consolidate, how are you going to fix up the dimensions, and everything. So that's where we talk about the row definition. So ultimately, rows are the lines for each report. These may be accounts or the group of accounts that represents, for instance, sales versus cost of sales versus expenses. Then we have column definitions. So definitely I'm going to link to this particular page here where we are talking about different columns. So if you remember the kind of report that we generated, there we saw the column 2018 and 19 and the consolidated year to date. Similarly, those are the set columns, and that is also that we can define on our own. So columns are usually the periods that are comparing, like current month and year to date. They can also be comparatives like present, percent of sales or percent of variance between the budget for a month and the month actual. So columns also looks after the headers of the reports as well, which is a very, very important factor. And I'll relate this to your understanding on the platform once we start creating one simple report on our own as well. So the columns also look after the headers of the report. I repeat, this is going to be a very important factor because the headers are going to help you to define the alignment of your reporting structure as well. Reporting definition is about uses a row, a column, and a reporting tree definition to build a report. So that means it consolidates all your rows, all your columns, and then you prepare one name as a simple management reporter. That's your financial report. So it provides additional options and settings that you want to run through that particular report. Reporting tree definitions. Tree allows the user to produce multiple reports, usually by department or division, that roll up to top level report. So trees are optional. If you use no tree, your report will show figures for all departments and divisions together. Now, before we go ahead, let me just take you back to the platform. Let's just close this. I'm not going to save anything that we have run in the past. So right now, I am back on my role center. That's my home page. Now, once I am on my home page, I have to create a new report on my own. So what am I going to do is, I'm just going to run down to general ledger. In my expanded view on my area page, I'm going to click down on reports and click on management reporter as a form. Once I have this particular management reporter, and I get this as a report designer. So this page is known as a report designer. All right. These are my report definitions and my elements. So report definitions is all about your template names. That is the names of your different default report definitions that we have. These are my elements. Elements, you will be able to recollect the kind of pointers that we spoke on our presentation as well, starting with report schedules, reporting tree definition, column definitions, row definitions, and report definitions. Now, I'm going to teach you how are we supposed to use these elements and create one report on. I will take you to report schedules first. Once I click on the element, I have to go back to my action pane here. On the left-hand side top corner, you see my cursor is hovering around to the new button. If I click on the drop-down, I'm just going to select the element that I have clicked, report schedule. And this is the setup that you will run on. So this is an initial setup that you want to trigger to your system, saying that what is the kind of individual report. So you can run a specific report from here. You can have the different report groups as well. So these are different settings that you can plan out for. Then you also have your security. So this is more of your credentials from where you are creating or running the report. The kind of frequency, that is the reoccurrences of the report that you want to plan out. So when do you want to run these kind of reports is something that you will talk about in your frequency tab. All right. Starting from which date to run the report at what specific time. If you talk about daily, what are the intervals or every weekdays, weekly, monthly and yearly. So every option that you choose here is going to change the filter out here as well. The range of reoccurrences, no end date, set the number of reoccurrences and end by. So even if you want to define any expiration or any deadline, you can plan out that range of reoccurrences also. If you do not want to have an end to that reoccurrences, definitely you can say no end date. So that's about your report schedules. Step one. All right. Then we go to the step two. That is my report definition in my elements. So I have to just go back to my new trigger to report definition. Once that is done, you will see a specific page which gets opened over here. Now, these are the names from where you actually start creating your reports. That's my step two. Step one was my report schedule. Step two is my report definition. So when I talk about different options here, about my legal entity, that's my company name that I want to keep it here. Like for which company am I creating this? Detail level is about, as we spoke, on what parameters do you want to run this report and have the information? So I'm just going to keep it as financial account and transactions. Provisional, link to your detail level on what parameters you want to have the report run on. Touching down again as a revision, the currencies of reporting currencies can be used. The date intervals can be planned out. And now we come to a very important factor, that's my building blocks. As I said earlier, I'm going to talk about these building blocks in details. All right. So right now, what are we going to do before we create the name for our specific report? This is the form which you can actually come back once you have complete the report designing. So it's not a thumb rule that you have to give the name to the report first and then enter the designing of it. No, you can design and then you can come back and give the final name to your report, which is going to be known as your report definition. So for now, what are we going to do is, as we saw schedules, we saw definitions, which is the naming of your report. We directly go in the designing, starts with column definition. So I'm just going to click on element column, go back to my new, click on my column definition, and you will see the Excel, which is done over here. I'm going to run this report for 6 months as a scenario. I'm planning out a 6 month report. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to have these columns framed out. These are my column names for what we can use it. And I'm going to plan first the alignment of my report. So I'm going to leave the header one and header three for the alignment purpose and utilize my header two only. Similar to the column, I'm going to leave column A for the alignment purpose and for my formulas. And I'm going to start using and designing the report from column B. So I'm going to utilize header two and shift to column B here. Let's plan out my report, which can be Q1. Let's plan out for quarter. Let's change the plan. So we'll go for quarter ways. So quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, and quarter four. So we are going to have a report designer where we are going to talk about four quarters. All right. Now, when I have planned out four quarters, what are the elements that I want to use here? That under quarters in the columns also, what I want to define the column type as. So what I'm going to do is column type is the place. In my column A, I'm going to define the formulas. Once I double click on that particular box, you will be able to understand. Do you want amounts from financial dimensions? Do you want to have calculated columns? Do you want to have row descriptions? Do you want to have row definition codes and so on? So with a very simple example, let me just take the amounts from financial dimensions. Now, this is where it talks about financial dimensions, actuals. Then it comes as a base fiscal year. Then I have a base period. I have periodic covers, formulas, and then column width. All right. So this is something which I am looking forward in my columns. So definitely I'm going to look forward this particular for my all four quarters. All right. So I've quickly copied it. Now, just the column definition is not going to help me. I also have to trigger my row definition. So I'm going to change my formula from here, come down to row descriptions. I have to define the row descriptions as well. So with the row description, I'm just going to quickly cover the period. As we are talking about different quarters to be here in the columns, I'm going to look for period. Under period, I'm going to define my quarters. That is 1:3. That becomes my first quarter. That is January, February, and March. Going to that third, 4:6. That is April, May, and June. Then comes as July, August, and September. October, November, and December. So that's how I've defined my quarter periods. All right. So now with this, what I do is I feel this is something which I want at max. So I'm going to simply save the column definition for now. Here in AX, the simple way that you can save is just press Control S, or you can use your save button right from your action pane as well. So save as, I'm just going to name this as Management Reporter US MF Test. Okay. Now, after that, I'm just going to write description as session demo. All right. And I'm just going to say, okay, that means my column that I have created for my report, I'm going to save that by this particular name. So column definition is ready for me. I'm just going to quickly say, okay. All right. And when I just go back on my elements here, definitions, you will see the report that I have created is already reflected over here. Do you see my cursor? This is where I have highlighted that is already saved in my column definition. Now quickly, we will go to the step four, that is my row definition. So I'm just going to click on row definition as an element, go to my new and click on row definition. Now this is the place where I will be defining the lot of rows. Before I go here, this is going to be absolutely blank. A lot of people will get confused, like what trainer is talking about. Can you just show me a real life example? So I am going to run a specific row defined report over here. So let me just open a specific report already, which is in place. All right. So under the row, we have balance sheet as a specific report. Now, looking at this report, the way it is created, the rows have been defined. You will understand the elements, the values have been listed down here. In row A, it's all about the row numbers. Description is all about the values that you want to check out over here. Maybe your current assets. Then you have what are your assets, the different cash and bank main accounts. Then you have your totals. Then you have securities. All right, let me just scroll down and just have a view. Then you have totals. Again, you have accounts receivable. So under receivables also, you have different components. Then you have your other current assets, you have physical inventories, and so on. So it's the way you want to define and you want to have the values to be there in place in your row definition. All right. Now, as we are already here, my format code is about my formulas. Related formulas, rows here, you have to define, right, whatever is the total. For example, I want to have the total of all these descriptions. That is right from 160 till 610. And that is how you will be defining your third row as formulas to calculate on the values of those specific row definitions that you have included. Now, once you have all these values in place, you have the formula set out in place. How are you going to link to which main accounts, which cost centers, and which departments supposed to be included in your report? The last column that you see, linked to your financial dimensions. It's a very, very important column for you. How are you going to define your different dimension sets over here? I'm going to simply click down, double click on these boxes. So these are my dimensions which are going to be set out. Now you will see a lot of collapsed view of my dimension sets, which is maybe a little confusing for a lot of people. Of course, for me as well. What am I going to do is I'm just going to click on my definition dimensions. I'll see if I have any other dimension set that I can look for. All right. If I feel I do not want this particular dimensions here, I can quickly go and click on this particular manage dimension set button. Here it will ask me, do you want to create a new one? I'll say yes. I'll say new. I'll name it as management report of USMF final dimension. It. Of course, we don't want to have so much of big names, but I'm just keeping it a little more precise right now for the session. Sorry for this. Just allow me to correct this. All right. And in the description, I'm just set session. Yeah. Now I'm going to talk about the available items, that what are the different dimension sets that I want to create on my own. So whenever I'm going to define my row for my specific report that I have created, I want my departments. So I'm going to select and push it to the included items. That means I require it. So I'm going to select that value and push it to my included items. Similarly, I will say cost center and I'll include it. Let me just scroll down and see what all other values do I have. Let's take my main account and go for my included items. I stop myself here and say that this is all what I want to be linked to my financial dimensions when I'm talking about the different row definitions, the different values in my row. So all the factors that I have created should be linked to these departments, cost centers, and main account. That means I am asking my system that whatever descriptions that I have placed, only these departments, cost centers, and main accounts needs to be included in my report. I'm sure a lot of people here have already been aware of what are financial dimensions. So let me just say, okay. And you will see there is another dimension set by the name that we had created is created. All right. I'm just going to say close. The moment I say close, and if I click down on the arrow, that particular dimension set is going to be reflected over here. You see this? And if I click on it, you will see the things that I had included over here. That was department, cost center, and main account. Now, let me quickly define which department do I want. And if I select that department, which cost center needs to be utilized. And if that is the cost center, which main account it should be reflected to. So that's a kind of a chain that I'm going to create over here. So I'm just going to click on department. Here it comes to the department to look for. I'm just going to click on this and have the list of my different departments. So I'm just going to say from 2000 to 2022, that is my sales and marketing. If I want to keep it to just one single department, I can use the same department number over here. And if I want to select the range of departments, I can just simply go and say from and to. That is from number 22 to 26 is the kind of departments that I want to include for this particular report. Quickly say okay. Similarly, I'm going to go for the cost center as well, and I'll talk about cost center. So cost center, if I want, I'm just going to say that is, let's say, marketing campaign. That's the only cost center that I want to have included in my report. So I'm just going to keep it only marketing campaign and say, okay. So cost center is defined and in place. And in the main account also, I can see like which main accounts. So here comes as main account. Okay. And let me just see here. I'm going to keep it to, because that was the first account, that's the reason. Let me just keep it to 140. And I'll say OK. The moment I say OK, I have my main account sets also described. So once my definition, that is the link of financial definition, is ready, I have linked my accounts, my main accounts, my departments, and my cost centers are in place, I'm simply going to say OK. And you will see here the formula has got changed. If at all I want to change this formula, I can simply just copy and paste it over here. All right. That means I am just asking my system that this is going to be the formula. That's my dimension set, which is going to be linked to these description values over in my report while I'm defining the rows over here. All right. I'm just going to simply say Control S and save it. All right. So what we have done, I'm going to take a little space, a kind of an additional revision part over here. I'm just going to minimize right now on my screen. Let me take the help. So what we saw as a revision, first we saw about our report schedule. That's about our setups, settings, about reoccurrences, when do you want the reports to generate, all those. All right. After that, then we have our report definition. All right. This is something which you can do it at the later part also. So this is more about your final names and setups. This is something, an optional, that you can capture it later on also. Third, we covered about how to create different column definitions. That is, we defined the columns that I want to be run in my new report. That is, we have defined a new column definition. Then we saw an existing row definition. That was the balance sheet where we created the different dimension sets. So we used the existing and we did some changes on our dimension sets. All right. Now, after we have done this, I'm going to go back. After I have defined the columns and the row, I'm just going to go back to the report definition on my system and do the final stage of my report. Let's just go back. Once I come here, all right, so this was about my balance sheet. Now I go back to report definition, click on new, click on report definition. I say yes. Just go back to report definitions. Okay. All right. I'll say no for now. All right. Now here comes the final naming of my report. So what I'm going to do is I'll check on the company. I'll change the detail level. Now this is the last stage of my new created report. I'm going to keep it as the base period 12 because we have spoken about quarters and the total year in our report. So I'm just going to keep it as base period 12. Base year I'm going to include as 2018. And I'll keep this as S1. That is my last period. Now here in the building blocks comes the place where I'm going to finally link the new reports to. So what is the column block? That is the building block on the column part that you're going to utilize. I'm just going to click on the drop down in the column, look for the report that I have created. That was my management report or USMF test. So that's the definition. That's the template that I want to use as a column definition for my new report. All right. Then in the rows, I'll just go back to the drop down. And here we had used the existing balance sheet as a row definition template. All right. Now, before we go ahead and save this also, I want to just recheck that if I use the right rows and the column definitions, I can simply click on this button and which will direct me to the place where I've created that report. So my columns is in place. Let me just close this. My rows. All right. So I have changed the formula. Everything is in place. Close. Now, once I feel that everything is perfect to go, the tree type here, which is very much optional. You can use your reporting tree or you can use your any of the organization hierarchy. If it is organization hierarchy, you can have the different other options where you want to use those hierarchies and so on. So right now we are not using this because we have not created one. But yes, as a piece of knowledge sharing, we can also have the organizational hierarchies to be implemented, linked to your financial reports. So that's with the kind of organizational pattern and the report that you want to run on. So tree definition is always an optional feature which you can choose. So right now I'm just going to say Control S and do the final saving of my report. So I'm just going to say this as management reporter final, and the description, I'm just going to write it as session test report. And I'm going to simply say, okay, all right. I might have used a space. All right, it's there. See, whenever I give a space after the final word, the system will give me an error, just like the way it gave it to me right now. So I have to check on my spaces after the word. Every space is also going to be counted as one space value. So you have to make sure once you type the whole name, you cannot use a space button. So once I've just removed the space after final, I'm just going to say, okay. And it did save my report. All right. Now, what am I going to do is I'm just going to look for the report that I have created. Here it comes. Management reporter final. So that's the customized or the new created report definition that I have. All right. And where it is the default setup is under default report definition. The newly created ones will just appear above the default report definition always. So I'm just going to click on the one which I have created right now. Once I click it, I'm just going to quickly go and say, okay, the rest of the setups is already taken place. I'm just going to say generate. Similarly, we have to be very patient here to let the system run the report in the said format that we have. So I'm just going to keep refreshing it just like last time. And let's wait for that report to get reflected on our screen. Allow me a couple of minutes more, please. It takes time, definitely, because see, it's again a financial report that we are generating. So we have to be very patient enough to ask the system to accumulate and gather all the database accurately and run the report. So here comes our management report. Of course, there are no figures right now because depending on the year that I had displayed, there are very less figures under those values. And wherever it has to be, the values have been displayed in my report. See, all right. And the major reflection here is about the column that we had created. So I hope you have got an idea how do we create our new columns or a new report format. So that was my management report final. That's the name here, which is reflecting the row definition, which I had used from the existing row definition that was balance sheet format, and the column there, which I had designed on my own, which was my quarter of the year, all the four quarters of my year. So this is how my report gets designed. On the report itself, you also have an option to go to your different modules and check your show button, which is going to reflect how the display or how you want the report to be reflected, like just the charts and comments or the headers and footers, summary lines only. The currencies can be changed. So if you want the report to be generated in other currencies, you can do that right from here. The font size through the Zoom button can be played around here. And you can also download the report and attach or keep it to your records. And there are certain setups you can talk about. This is how your management reporter actually functions on your AX platform. All right. And I've also shown you how the report, the existing default report format runs, and how can we create a report of our own. All right. So with this, actually, we just go back to our slides and understand what all things we have covered and spoken about. All right. So if you remember, I'm just going to take you back. Report design is the place where we define the report, design the report. Report schedule is about your setups. Row definition is about what description values do you need to have in your rows. Columns is about the different columns that you want to run the report in. That is your column definition. And the report definition is the final setup of your report that you have created, includes your rows, your columns, and your tree definition as well to build one single report for final. Reporting tree definition, as I said, it is an optional feature. So trees are optional. If you use no tree, if you do not use this functionality, your report will show figures for all the departments and divisions together. All right. So that means there is no filter. It is going to be considered as a plain report for all the departments and the divisions together. Here we come to the end of our session. I believe this was very much knowledgeable and a little knowledge sharing from my end as a trainer. That was one of the functionalities a lot of people here in the session would have been working and have been working on management reporter under AX in their respective projects. So maybe today's session has actually caused and helped you out to understand management reporter much better way. So if I keep this particular time now for questions, so if you have any questions, you can list down in the chat box and maybe I can address those questions. So we have like another 10 minutes to go and we are here to help you out with your queries, please. Over to you, Nicole, maybe Rupali, until unless till the time we have some queries from our session. So can we have some questions, please? All right. So there was Mr. Sunil. Is it available in D365 FNO? Yes, Mr. Sunil, this particular functionality is going to be available in your general ledger module in your finance and operations platform as well. And under the ledger setup, and then once you go to your reports, you have an option called financial reports. So from there, you will be functioning same way the way we have in our management reporter as well. So it's just the entry path is going to be a little slightly different from our AX platform to our FNO also. But the rest of the functionalities, the way you design, the way you run the default reports is exactly the same that you have seen right now on my platform. I hope that answers your query, Mr. Sunil. All right. Any other questions? All right. So we have, thank you for your feedback. Thank you so much for this wonderful session. It's really been beneficial. Thank you. We appreciate as a team that it has been a good knowledge sharing for you. So we keep imparting knowledge this way on various platforms and various topics. So it was appreciated. Very good feedback. Okay, I'm requesting for the recorded video. All right. Recorded video is something where, Rupali, if you can just help us out with this particular query.
Hi, Urvashi. Thank you for that lovely session. And yes. Some questions for me. Recorded session. Yeah, the recording session will be available for you. After 48 hours of the webinar, it will be uploaded on our website. I'll be sharing the URL for that as well. And kindly everyone fill in the attendance sheet as well for the webinar certificates. And if anybody wants to continue for this course or wants to enroll for this training, I'll be sharing my email in the chat. Kindly forward me the details so that our expert will get back to you with the required details for that course. Thank you for joining, and over to you, Urvashi, for the further Q&As, and keep joining and keep liking us on the social media. Thank you.
All right, thanks. So we still have little time, as my team mate has already made a lot of clarity in terms of the recordings and the other operational part on it. But we are still open. We still have a little time to address and help you out with your questions. So if you have any questions, we are still available. Just take the best advantage of this time that we have left with, and we can address your questions as well. Thank you, everyone. People who have just liked the session, it really means a lot as a team, and that we could be of help in our knowledge sharing. Thank you very much. All right. So my teammate has already shared the recording of the webinar details, and how are we going to grab the recordings as well. Also, he has mentioned a particular link in the chat box. If at all, you all can just go back to the chat box and see. He has mentioned if we want to enroll and we want to have more details about this course and learn about AX, there is a specific email ID that he has mentioned. You can reach out to my teammate, and from there, the further process will be handled by him. We still have a little time. Let us know with the questions. I'm still open to have and address your respective questions, if at all. Guys, we still have 5 minutes. See, this is the best time where we can talk about any specific question that we have in our mind before we go with the confidence that, okay, this is the right course that we have to go ahead with. So if you have any questions, let us know. We are there to help you out, please. Okay, Nick, well, I did not understand the query that you put up. Like, you did request for a special trainer, a specific course, but you did not get feedback. Maybe that, can you just let us know what was the exact issue? Or we can understand, do we need to speak about it right now? Or we can have a separate call with you. Was it a special trainer for a specific course that you're talking about? All right. I would appreciate if you can just allow us some time to get back to you, because my teammate is going to get back to you on that specific query, because it's an individual query where we can have a detailed discussion about it. I hope you understand that, please. So Nick has already shared his email ID and he'll get back to you on that particular specific requirement that you have mentioned. Will that be okay? All right. Thank you very much to understand. Thanks. So Sunil had a query, but he's already left the session. Any other questions, please? We still have 4 minutes to go. All right. I still keep it open to the session. We are there to help you out. We have another 4 minutes to go. So in this 4 minutes, you can just take the best of the advantage to ask the specific query clear and loud in the session itself. And otherwise, also, we are there to help you out on the email ID, which is mentioned in the chat box for any specific queries later on also. So thank you very much for that. We still appreciate questions coming in. All right, Nicole, you can take up the closure. I believe the questions have been already addressed. So if you want to get onto the closure part of it, over to you, please. Nicole? You want to really take up? Thank you,
Urvashi, for that lovely session. Thank you, everyone, for joining as well. Hope to see you soon in the upcoming webinars. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you, Urvashi.
All right. Thank you.